What's going on, everyone? This is Dustin Stelzer from Electrician U, and today we're going to talk about how you no longer need to be using Nolux on your aluminum wiring. Yeah, that'll get a lot of people pissed off. So that's a pretty bold statement. Nolux, what is Nolux? Really, Nolux is an anti-oxidizing compound. Not even really anti-oxidizing, it's just an oxide inhibitor. Meaning that if you use aluminum and you introduce aluminum to water or to air, it's gonna create oxides on the outside of that aluminum. And so a lot of people for a lot of years have been using what we call pookie or Nolux. No aluminum oxidization. So the reason that this stuff has been used for so long is that a long time ago, aluminum wiring was made of just pure aluminum, and then they started introducing different alloys to it, and by the 80s, they had really perfected putting alloys together. So nowadays, the aluminum that we use, most of it is a AA8800 aluminum alloy. Meaning that it's mixed with other metals, so it doesn't still react the same way as normal aluminum does. So I see people putting this stuff on service conductors and anything aluminum, they're just scared. Aluminum, you gotta put this stuff on. But the cool thing about it is the 8800 or AA8800 aluminum oxide, even when you mix it with copper, it still does not cause the same galvanic action. It doesn't corrode one another like they used to. And we've been using that same stuff since the 80s. So all these electricians out there and all these like home inspectors and homeowners and everybody are so freaked out by this whole aluminum phenomenon. But it's stuff that for the last, like, I don't know, 30 or 40s just hasn't been a problem anymore. The problem with aluminum most of the time is the people that are putting it in are not tightening things to proper torque specifications, or when they're using like number 12 aluminum to hook an outlet up, they're not tightening that all the way down, or they're not using Kolar devices, which are approved devices for aluminum wire. So there's other issues, but I am here to say, my friends, you no longer need to be using this shit out in the field. There are a couple of circumstances in which it's just maybe a good idea, like if you're in Florida or, you know, down at the coast somewhere and you've got salt water. Salt and air and water really, really corrode metals. So not even just the conductors that you're installing, but the actual terminals, the screws, everything metal around those areas corrodes really, really quickly. So in an environment like that, I would probably still use this. It's not gonna hurt. But the other issue is that people are not using this properly even when they are using it. A lot of people, when they have these big conductors, as big as my finger, they take this thing off, they dip the conductor inside of it, pull it out, it's just full of the stuff, and then they stick it in the terminal and use it. So that brings up the instructions of how this is supposed to be used. That is not how you use it. So per the manufacturer's instructions, this one even says on the bottle, directions for use. Number one, clean the conductor surface with a wire brush or an emery cloth. Nobody does that. Nobody keeps a wire brush around and brushes the ends of these terminations. Apply Nolux freely to both the conductor and the connector. A lot of people don't do that. They just dip the wire in. And then number three is assemble joint and wipe off the excess. A lot of people don't do that either. A lot of inspectors out there love to see like goops of this shit just coming out of these lugs and terminals. And that's not what it's supposed to be used for. So there's almost nobody even installing this right how it's supposed to be used. There's no code article in the NEC that says that you have to use it in the first place. But there is mention in 110.14 that when you use a compound, when one of these is employed, that you have to use it correctly. And the closest thing that we get is 110.3b, where it says that anything that you use has to be used to manufacturer's specifications. So the NEC doesn't require us to use it. Some authorities out there that have jurisdiction, some of like, you know, the cities that come and inspect your work, some people, they rewrite their own code and they want you to use this stuff. That's fine. And in those situations, you just don't have any other choice. You have to. There's nothing wrong with putting this stuff on. You're not going to be hurting anything when you do it. It's just not necessary. Again, the aluminum that we're using in our conductors nowadays, we don't have the problems that required people to use this. So I think there's just a lot of miseducation about it out there. So what this does when you put it on a conductor is it creates an air and moisture barrier. And that's why a lot of people will just dunk it in there and make sure that everything is like gooped up around the termination point. But the real important thing is to get around every single one of the conductors. So if you've got a really, really large conductor this big, it's a stranded conductor. So it's got all kinds of strands. But you can't get it in between every single thing. So you're supposed to get it in between all the little cracks and crevices more than you're supposed to just get it on the outside of the conductor, because those are the points that are going to be moving and flexing and changing. And those are going to be the ones that are really hit with corrosion the worst. One other thing to note is that there are some panels or enclosures out there. They require you to use some sort of anti-oxidizing compound when you install stuff, but it'll actually say there on that piece of equipment. And with code, we always have to go with whatever the manufacturer's specs are. So the two places where you still need to be using this, anytime a manufacturer calls for it, anytime a conductor calls for it, if a conductor that's aluminum is not made of AA8800 aluminum, it will call for you needing to use this kind of compound. And then the other instance that you're gonna need it is if you're working in a really, really corrosive environment where you probably should be using something to help out in any way that you can. And then lastly, if you have an AHJ or like a local inspector or something, and that's their code that they've written and they require it, you just have to do it.
Three, my lord.
Oh, okay. So, hope that taught you something for your noggin. Love you crazy people, and I'll see you in the next episode.